Okay, so I am a total JavaScript noob, so don't worry, this won't be any kind of boring tutorial. But I do want to show you something I've been working on and been struggling on with JavaScript. Let's take a look. So quickly setting the scene, I pull in tweets from a list on Twitter and I filter that list based on muted words, language, a couple of other criteria. And that list is what I'm looking at here. So there are two actions I can do, deny a tweet or save it. Now, if you want to know more about why I do all of this, just ask me in the comments. But for now, it's enough to know about these two actions, saving and denying tweets. And I usually use my phone to do so. And you can see I have these two buttons to save and deny a tweet, but I actually want to use touch gestures, just like many apps on iPhone do, like swipe to the left and to the right to perform a different action. And so that's what I'm building from scratch today. I won't use any JavaScript frameworks. I won't even compile or bundle or whatever my JavaScript. Just write a script in a blade file. Easy. Like I said, I'm a noob. So my first idea was to use mouse events to detect dragging, but that quickly turned out to be a bad idea. Luckily, there's the touch API that's made for exactly what I want to do. So you have a touch start, move, and end event. And with every move, there's a new event containing the coordinates of the specific touch position, which I can use to determine the position of one tweet and in the end have it trigger an API call to either save or deny that specific tweet. Now, the most important metric is to know how much distance I've dragged a tweet, because that distance will determine when the API call is triggered. I only want that to happen at a certain threshold. And so I started with a simple div that I could drag left or right. And as soon as a touch start event fires, I will keep track of its starting coordinates and determine the dragged distance for every subsequent drag event based on that start position. Now, when the touch end event is fired, I'll determine what to do. If the threshold or border is reached, we'll perform an API request, and otherwise we'll reset everything back to normal. So once I have border detection in place, I can start adding visuals to let the user know that the action, the API call, will actually happen. And I do that by giving the dragged div another background color so that the user knows if I release my touch now, something will happen. It's time to move my code so that I'm actually working with the tweets and not a dummy div, and also spend some time on styling everything. And now we have a first working proof of concept, at least from a visual point of view. We still need to hook up the API calls. So let's add these URLs and use the fetch API. Apparently that's how HTTP requests are done these days in JavaScript. Like I said, I'm a total noob, but I like it. I need to add my CSRF token as well. This is a Laravel app that comes by default. And it looks like we've got everything hooked up. Oh, one last thing I noticed before pushing this is that the vertical and horizontal dragging sometimes interferes. Now, I will have to fine tune this in the next video, but for now I'm simply going to add a little delay to triggering my custom dragging behavior so that I can actually start testing on my phone. So pushing everything now, making some last minute CSS changes, and let's try it out. So I think it turned out pretty well, but there are still a lot of improvements to be made. My JavaScript code is a total mess. There are some quirks that I need to fix and some styling issues as well. But that's going to be addressed in the next video. For now, leave a like, comment, subscribe. You know what to do. And maybe even check out this other video I made.